Hi everyone, welcome to the course Writing 2. This is Ms. Niu Zheng from the Faculty of Foreign Languages, University of Technology and Education. In this unit, we are going to learn the definition of a paragraph, the parts of a paragraph, and how to identify and write topic sentences. This is a sample paragraph for you. After looking at the sample paragraph, can you identify the different parts of a paragraph? First one, let's take a look at the first question. What is a paragraph? It is a group of sentences about a single topic. All sentences explain the writer's main idea about the topic. A paragraph is often between 5 and 10 sentences long, and the first sentence is indented a few spaces. Now, please read this paragraph. It is the beginning of an article about Switzerland in a student newspaper. Then we have some questions to answer. First one, can you identify the topic of the paragraph? What is the main idea about the topic? And what ideas help explain the main idea? The paragraph organization is like this. First one, we have the topic sentence. This is the main idea of the paragraph. It is usually the first sentence of the paragraph, and it is the most general sentence of the paragraph. The second part is the supporting sentences. The supporting sentences are the sentences that talk about or explain the topic sentence. They are more detailed ideas that follow the topic sentence. And the last part is the concluding sentence. This may be found as the last sentence of a paragraph, and it can finish a paragraph by repeating the main idea or just giving a final comment about the topic. Now let's take a look at the sample paragraph again. As the theory suggests, we can see that the first sentence of this paragraph is the topic sentence. And then after that, we have different ideas, detailed ideas to support the topic sentence. The last sentence, that is the final comment about the topic sentence, so it is the concluding sentence. Now let's move on to the next part. You are going to see different groups of sentences. Decide whether they are good paragraphs or not. And why are the other groups of sentences are not good paragraphs? Now let's turn back to our theory. What is a topic sentence? The topic sentence usually comes first in a paragraph. It gives the writer's main idea or opinion about the topic and helps the reader understand what the paragraph is going to talk about. Take a look at the following sentences. Find out the topic of each sentence and the main idea about the topic. For each of these paragraphs, choose the sentence from the list which would make the best topic sentence. Take a look at the following examples. Which of the following examples cannot be used as a topic sentence and why? We have here three sentences. Can you identify them? For the first sentence, my hometown is famous for several amazing natural features. This one is too general, right? And it is a fact. The second sentence is also not a good topic sentence. Why? Because we have two parts here with two clauses of a sentence. The first part focuses on the two reasons why people like to buy cars with automatic transmissions. The other part focuses on the two reasons why others like to buy cars with manual transmissions. So, we have too many ideas in one sentence. The Last sentence, clouds are white. This is a fact, and it is not necessary to prove this. Here are some suggested topics for you to practice writing a topic sentence. Let's review a little bit. These sentences are mixed up parts of one paragraph. Can you number the parts in order? Here are the results. Now let's summarize all the main points. What is a paragraph? Do you remember? It is a group of sentences, yes, and it has a clear main idea. It has supporting information, and it can be a part of a longer composition. You can consider a paragraph as a miniature essay. Use the words and phrases in the box to complete the sentences. Here are the results. This is a process for you to write a paragraph. There are 5 steps to write a good paragraph. The first step is brainstorming. When you have a topic to deal with, the first step is to think and write down any ideas about the topic you want to write about. The second step is to organize ideas. You need to organize your ideas by creating a cluster or an outline about what you want to write about. Then, we come to the next step, writing the first draft. When you have all the ideas you want to write, then begin to write your paragraph for the first time, not taking much information account about cohesion, coherence, grammar, or spelling. Just write and try to put your ideas into the paragraph. After writing the first draft, we come to the next step, editing. Revise all errors about coherence and cohesion that your paragraph may have. This part may take a lot of time, but it doesn't matter. You can spend a lot of time revising and revising again and again. After editing the paragraph, you come to the last step, publishing. You revise all spelling or grammar errors. Make sure that you don't make silly mistakes. And here you go with the final result. This is a mind map of possibilities for paragraph development. This one can be considered as your reference. Now we come to the next part of the lesson, the development of a paragraph. You will learn the methods of paragraph support and development, how to write concluding sentences, and how to do peer editing. So, how can you develop a paragraph? There are 3 ways for you to choose. The first one is to give details. The second one is to give an explanation. Or the third way is to give an example. Now let's take a look at the first task. Details are specific points that tell more about the general statement. Now read this brochure from a health club. Notice the details that help develop the paragraph. Can you identify the topic sentence? Of course, it is the first one. So what is a supporting sentence? A supporting sentence develops, explains, and supports the main idea of the paragraph. It contains facts, examples, and details. It explains why the main idea is true. Here are some examples of supporting sentences. How about an explanation? An explanation tells the reader what something means or how something works, which means the writer will explain. In this paragraph, underline the topic sentence and answer the 2 questions that follow. Giving an example is another way to support the topic sentence. An example is a specific person, place, thing, or event that supports an idea or statement. The paragraph below includes an example from the writer's own experience. Can you identify the example? What do you think the writer chose to use an example to develop the paragraph? It may be because a personal experience can remind the readers of their own experience.Now take a look at this task, choosing a means of support. Could you develop each of these topics with details, an explanation, or an example? Explain your choices to a partner. We have here 5 topics for you to choose. Remember that more than one answer is possible. Here is a list of linkers for you to show different relationships between ideas in a paragraph.Now, let's develop your own paragraph. Look back at the topic sentences you wrote earlier. Follow the 4 steps here.